hearing a train coming. That means the end of your course. Your course is over. It's done. It's kaput. What are you going to do now? Well, I got a solution for you. I got something to think about. Let's go on from here to this notion of archiving, ending, updating, and reusing your online course. Yeah, that's what you need to do. You need to think about where you're going. You got all the stuff in this big bucket. Audio clips, video clips, graphs, maps, labs, cases, assessments, tutorials, text, charts, labs, illustrations, diagrams. You got all the stuff. What are you going to do with it? You got to save it. You got to save it. You got to think about saving it, right? You got to design your personal plan for saving your stuff. You got all the stuff. But you got to, you know, go back to the old days when we had, you know, what, CDs to save things in, right? This is how we saved our work. Get permission from students. If they've designed something, get their permission to include their work in galleries, in examples, models, and so forth. Also take time to update. You've got all this content, rich content. Spend an hour, spend a day, spend a half a day, whatever it is, to update it so you can reuse that stuff. Because that train whistle is going to come, and you're going to have to be ready for it. So think about sharing content between classes, reusing, interoperability between classes. Think about backup plans. You know, in the old days, we had to think about, right, all these CD backups that we're going to make. Tons and tons of CDs. Not today. Today, we got stuff up in the cloud, up in the ether somewhere that's being saved for us on servers, your servers, university school servers, someone else's server. Get support. Talk to your instructional consulting office, your teaching and learning center, and ask them what to do about saving that content, reusing that content, updating that content. There's exams you might want to reuse or change. There are web-based lectures, webcasts that you've done. Maybe you had a good one. Save it for next time. Or a podcast, right? You put your little headset on again. You did your podcast. Well, you want to save that podcast. Find that exemplary stuff. Archive it. Review. Look at other courses that are out there and see what they've done in terms of archiving. What pieces that they've saved and their review policies. Think about the contents that you're using. Think about the purpose and scope of that content. Who was using it in that class. The length of that content. Interactivity. Technical requirements. And then think about, do you want to update it or not? Maybe you don't want to. When you've done all that, then you've got to get permission, as I said. And when you ask permission, what do students say? They say, let me make it better. Let me make it better. You don't get that in face-to-face classes. Oh, you know, Dr. Bonk, I want to make my stuff better after I got my grade. No, in an online class, you post this stuff on the web. There's an audience beyond the instructor. Students say, let me make it better. You can also get students to do a final assignment in a class where they volunteer to update your contents. And you might continue to update, accumulate more videos if you're using YouTube or TED videos or CNN videos, more web resources, more portals. Typically, you will be thinking, this is not going to be the best day of my life, updating my class, but you can actually make your courses better. Why not? My friend Jonathan Plucker does this in his class on human intelligence. And he's got one of those blow-you-away human intelligence portals that's just fabulous because of this. He's doing all the things I just mentioned. I've got videos in my learning theory class. Actually, Dr. Plucker and I both teach. And this learning theories video set, just the suite of videos, keeps it getting better and better and better. And students don't want to leave the class because they love watching the videos that connects the book and the content all together for them. Student project galleries, update them, reuse them. Create them. And soon you'll have one of those best practice classes. You'll be selected. Your course will come up because you've done all this within your classes. You have these examples you've saved that now you can showcase to the world or to your department chair or to your deans or colleagues. You can have festivals around your best contents, best videos, best projects, right? Advice. Now, remember, you're never going to feel your course is complete. You're going to continue to save contents and get rid of some things. You might need to spend a little bit of money. Maybe you have a small pot of money, $100, $200, $300, or $50 to hire a grad student, undergrad student to look through the contents. Or maybe you make it a final project, optional final project for students to search through your supplemental resources and give you feedbacks on what's there and flag things. You can flag things. Flag things. And look for ideas, new articles, new materials, new assignments that you can then use next time around, right? File that in a way, in a little file somewhere that you can keep track of. You know, look at what worked for you. What worked for you? And then make plans to use it next time. And what didn't work? And talk to students maybe about what worked and what didn't work. And make plans for next time you teach that class. Do some kind of formative or summative evaluations of your course content. Maybe have a rating sheet that your students check off things that, within the class of pieces that they really liked, they engaged with. Those things that maybe you can get rid of. Chunk it. Chunk the contents into usable units that maybe you share with a colleague and they can evaluate for you. Leave space within your course management system for things you can update and bring in. So have a filing system, both online and physical, that you leave space for new stuff, new contents, new ideas, new trends. Store things in different places. Maybe you have a flash memory stick that you've got a lot of content that you've put on that flash memory stick, so that you can find it in these terabyte data sticks eventually, right? But you also have it on CD, you might have it on a server, multiple places to find that content. You don't want to lose it. Let's just put it that way. Find out what your requirements are within your course management system, be it Blackboard or Moodle or WebCT or Desire to Learn or whatever system you happen to be using around the world. Find out the system requirements. Here at Indiana, we use OnCourse. So, and then think about moving, reusing. If your course management system is being updated, can you move and reuse? When do you need to move and reuse? What contents will go along and come along with you? What policies does your university have for taking contents with you if you move to another institution, or if you retire, or whatever you might plan to do in the future, move departments? Check out OpenCourseWare from MIT and Open Yale and stuff from hundreds of universities around the world that are freely shared. Compare your contents to them. Write to the authors and ask permission to use their contents if you get a chance to. So go to MIT OpenCourseWare or Open Yale. Go to the Open Education Resource Commons, OER Commons, or the Internet Archive, or the National Repository of Online Courses, NROC. Check out that Internet Archive from Brewster Cayley and other people, and the Wayback Machine. Thousands of courses up there at the Internet Archive. Millions of books. Lots of music, too, by the way. Some Jerry Garcia stuff, like this tie with my nano holder in the... Well, that's another story, but he has lots of old Grateful Dead stuff up there in the Internet Archive as well. Open Ed Resources. If you want to find a portal of portals of some of the most brilliant minds of the world have ever created, go to OER Commons. I think it's the one resource that's just really created a difference in the world during the past two decades. That's sharing contents. It's not just about archiving, but go to NROC, National Repository of Online Courses, which has both higher ed and K-12 contents. Update, reuse, and archive. Talk to your instructional consulting office out there about your policies. See if it's still being done on CD, if it is, or are you saving on flash memory sticks, right? Are you storing on a server or multiple people's server? That train is going to come calling for you. And you've got to be able to listen to the whistle, think about your class. Where are you going with this class? What's happening next with your contents, with your course? Talk to other people. This doesn't have to be a sad day in your life to be updating, archiving, and ending a course. Students get sad when you end. But it can be a chance of renewal, an opportunity for reflection and professional development. It might be the best day of your life. So take off with this archiving, updating, and reusing. Talk to instructional consulting. Talk to people you know. Believe me, it'll make a difference in the world because your course will be better. Good luck.